Okay. The definition of errors, as we had seen in the introduction module, numerical methods will lead to approximate solutions. So what that means is that the solution will differ from the actual value of the solution. The difference between the true solution and the approximate numerical solution is what we call the error. Okay. There are various reasons why these errors come about. These errors are classified into two different types, what is known as round off errors and truncation errors. We will talk about that in this particular module. Before we do that, we will just define what we mean by the error. We are going to use two different definitions of error. One is the small e over here is just the difference between x star, where x star is what we are representing the true value of the solution, and x a over here represents the approximate value of the solution. So the difference between the two is going to represent error. Again, we do not want to bias ourselves to positive or negative values, and therefore we are going to use the absolute value of that difference as our definition of error. This is what is known as the absolute error. Often what is important is not just the absolute value of error, but the value of error relative to the true value of the solution, and that is what is known as the relative error. And the relative error is defined as the difference in the true value minus the approximate value divided by the true value, the absolute value of that. Okay. So the reason for doing this is because an error of 0.1 is very large if the true value of the solution is say 0.2, but it is negligibly small if the true value of the solution is say 1000. Okay. So we need to differentiate between the error values what they really mean, and that is the reason why we have an absolute error and a relative error. Okay. This is the square root example from the Hinnon algorithm that we had talked about in the introduction lecture, and the xi plus 1 over here is an average between the previous value xi and 2 divided by xi. It's just an algebraic mean of these two values, and this is the curve that we had seen, the blue and the red curves which we saw in the previous module, and these are the approximate values of x and how these approximate values of x change with the iteration number. The black line over here represents the true solution x star. The difference between the true value and the approximate value is what we call the error. So e 0 over here is essentially this particular difference between 1.414 and 0.5. The value e 1 is essentially this particular difference, e 2 is essentially this difference, e 3 is this, e 4 is this, so on and so forth. Okay. So the definition of error really is that the absolute error is the difference between the true value and the approximate value. And the relative error is this difference divided by this particular true value of the solution. Okay. So that is as it goes with respect to the definition. What we mean by error propagation is the error e1 depends on the previous value x and the value x star, or in general it depends on the error e0. Likewise, error e2 depends on the value x1 as well as the error e1, so on and so forth. So what we see over here is the error e0 and the value x0 are going to determine what the next error e1 is going to be. That in turn determines what the next error e2 is going to be, what the next error e3 is going to be, and so on and so forth. An understanding of how this error propagates is going to be very important in analyzing these numerical techniques. Okay. So that is what these numerical techniques we are going to do in this particular lecture, is define the error, define what we mean by error propagation, and try to find out what are the reasons why this particular error comes about. Okay. Again, this is the square root example, and these are essentially the absolute errors. So this is 1.414 minus 0.5, the absolute value of that. 1.414 minus 2.25, the absolute value of that, so on and so forth. The column here, the last column over here, represents the error in the approximate solution. And as you can see, the error is quite significant. We start with an error of 0.9 and very quickly the error drops to 10 to the power minus 16. Okay. So, how this error behave as the iteration proceeds is going to be a very important property of any numerical technique, and that is what we are going to cover in the various different numerical techniques that we are going to talk about starting from the next module. Okay. And the question is, now what if we do not know x star? You know, in this particular example that we took, we knew what the true value of x star was going to be, but in general when we are going to use these numerical techniques, we do not know what this x star value is going to be. So, we define what is known as the approximation error. So, we represent this as EA, and again the EA at the ith iteration is the difference between the value that we have from the ith iteration and the value that we have from the I minus 1th iteration. And the relative error over there is again in the same way as in the previous case, we have defined that as epsilon A, and it is the difference divided by the true value of divided by the approximate value x I minus 1. Okay. And essentially what that particular definition means is that the difference between this value and this value is going to be E1. Difference between this and this value is going to be E2, E3, E4 and so on. And if you remember from the module 1, what we had said is we have stopped at iteration number 6. The reason why we stopped at iteration number 6 is because the result was not changing from the 5th iteration to the 6th iteration up to the desired accuracy that we were seeking. And the desired accuracy we were seeking over here is that the 6th decimal place should not change. Okay. So, the stopping criteria that we decided essentially was not based on whether the true value is reached or not, but whether there is a significant change with the iteration in the approximate value we have or not. Okay. And this is where the approximation error between ith and I minus 1th iteration comes very handy, is when we do not know the value of x star. Next, we are going to look at the causes of the errors. Before we do that, we will discuss about what we mean by precision, what we mean by accuracy, what we mean by significant digits. In the previous example, the significant digits that we looked at is essentially 7 significant digits. We know for sure that the solution is correct up to this particular number of digits. We do not know what happens beyond this particular point. So, we are interested essentially in 6 digits after the decimal point. In this particular case, there is 1 digit before the decimal point, and we are interested in the result up to the 7 significant digits. Okay. Next, we are going to look at what truncation error and round off error means. Again, we will go back to the workhorse Taylor series expansion and approximation of the Taylor series. We will talk about the computer, the binary number system, and the fact that computer is what is called a finite precision machine. And we will take an example of an infinite series of e to the power x in order to continue with this particular module.